Hello YouTube. Today we're going to be replacing the linear bearings on the y-axis of my Wanhao Duplicator I3. If you listen, you can hear that the bearing is dragging, and if you look closely at the linear rail, you can actually see pieces of bearing and grease building up on the rail. The first thing I'll need to do is raise the z-axis out of the way so that I can remove the build platform. I'll do this by going to position, and z-position fast. That should be enough. Now I can power down the Wanhao. The next thing I need to do is remove these four screws that hold the heated build platform to the table. So the next thing I need to do is remove the screws that hold the linear rail in place. Now I just need to remove the four screws that hold the right side bearing housing to the table. Should be able to lift the rod out now. You can hear the bearing is really dragging, and you can feel and see all the grease that shouldn't be that dirty. You can feel little chunks of bearing housing and stuff coming off in there. So now I need to remove one of these ends so that I can slide the bearing off. Now when I slide this bearing off, I'm going to cut my hand over the bearing so that none of the little balls and stuff come out and go all over the place. And there it is. Okay, the next step's going to be to remove this linear bearing from its housing. And to do that, I'm going to use this nifty pair of snap ring pliers and just reach in there and pull the snap ring out. And I'm hoping that this will just push out with my finger. We'll see. Yeah, good deal. Well, there's the old bearing. And the housing is fairly clean. Wipe it off right quick. There's a new bearing I got off Amazon. I put just a little bit of 3-in-1 on it to help it go in the housing. Pop it in. That one looks good and in there. This one here. Yeah, it's in there. Okay. So there's the bearing assembly rebuilt. And I've wiped off all the crud off this linear rail. And it's got a few scratches, but it's not too bad. I'm going to give it a little bit of 3-in-1 oil. And slide the bearing on it. That feels better. So a quick tip, when reassembling this, I couldn't figure out why it was so tight to go back together here. So when I would slide it, it was really dragging a lot. And I found out that I'd put this bearing on first, and then I tightened down the linear rail, and that was causing it to bind. So tighten down your linear rail first, and then snug your bearing up. And that should make it slide a lot easier. Alrighty, I got her all put back together and she sounds real good. I'm running a quick poodle print here to test it out, but I'm going to call this a success. The link to the bearings I use will be in the description. Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe.